When airborne, cats and drones will always level out so they can land on their feet. So what would happen if we did this? It's probably almost 10 years ago now that I first heard of the concept known as the butted cat paradox, which shouldn't be confused with butted cat, but the idea is that when a cat is dropped from a height, it always lands on its feet. Comparably, if you drop a piece of buttered toast, it'll always land face down. Based on this is an idea that if you strap a piece of buttered toast to the back of a cat and then drop the cat from a height, the toast and the cat will rotate perpetually, each trying to outmaneuver the other in an effort to land on the ground first. This perpetual motion could then be used as an infinite source of energy. Well, I guess until like starvation sets in or the cat gets extreme motion sickness. I don't know, I'm not a cat doctor. The question first came about back in 1988 during a routine by an entertainer named Michael Davies.
If a cat always lands on his feet and bread always lands butter side down, what would happen if you buttered your bread and strapped it on the back of a cat?
It has since been knocking around the place in various magazines and animations ever since. To my surprise though, some people have actually tested this out. However, like you'd guess, the results aren't looking that promising. For example, in this test and other similar tests on YouTube, like many people have noted, it's most likely failed because the strap interferes with the butter's special powers that make the toast land face down. And for this French guy, even though he did some solid groundwork on his Le Mouvement Perpetuel, I believe his experiment has likely failed because it appears he's used a dead cat. However, even if you change the cat's living status to not dead and the toast mounting issue is resolved, it appears the likely reason most of these attempts will fail is because buttered toast only has an 80% chance of landing buttered side down. Yeah, apparently proper research has also been done on this too. Unlike toast, however, a cat's ability to land on its feet is actually very consistent, and their technique for achieving it is pretty damn good. I've observed this myself with a machine I made to offer uninvited neighbourhood cats a drink in my backyard. But surprisingly, this has also been really well tested by others too. Dropping old school 1800s tabby toilet rug from a height was one of the first subjects to be used to test an early motion film camera. This camera captured 12 frames per second and was perfect for studying the motion of things for the very first time, including cats landing on their feet. It didn't prove too popular for children's portraits though, most likely because it looked like a gun. Oi, smile kid. So when a cat versus the ground, even when dropped upside down, the cat writing reflex always wins, unless the cat versus NASA. That's right, you smartass cats are buggered now. But we don't live in zero gravity, and I've always thought the secret to making this cat butter paradox work would be to get rid of the toast and simply strap two cats together back to back and drop them. Then, with the power of cat rotation and science and numbers and pi equations, we'll have the perfect perpetual motion machine and infinite power. To test this out, you'd think it'd be easy with my almost constant supply of neighbourhood cats, but I've never been able to successfully grab two of them, and if I did, some reason they're always wet and covered in confetti, so taping them together might be a bit hard. So, because of that, I shelved my free energy experiment idea, but I was still curious what would happen. Then a few years ago, I was watching YouTube, and there was this Australian video where they were demonstrating how the older DJI Phantom drone models could not only be tilted sideways, but could be completely inverted and dropped, and then like a cat, they'll do everything in their power to level out instantly. On a side note though, this doesn't work for modern drones, which just turn off if you turn them upside down, which is boring. They kind of just give up on life like a turtle on its back. On this video, I saw this comment though, and I thought, hell yes, I gotta try that. It's the closest thing I'll ever get to being able to test out my cat back-to-back idea. So I thought we gotta give this a go because at that time I happened to have exactly that. Two DJI Phantom drones, one that we use for filming stuff and the other I purchased to harvest its bits and pieces to turn into a flying esky. So before I chopped it up, I thought, yep, let's give this a go. And I filmed it and the footage has kind of just been sitting there and I haven't got around to editing it. And that's what this video is. Now science time. How do drones do this? Well, if we limit our research strictly to DJI promotional videos, it explains it well. Sometimes when drones are flying, they can explode, which is good because it shows us their secret inside bits. Look at all that cool stuff in there. There's like the circuit board and the other bit. The silver block, they're always good. Probably some springs and stuff in there as well. Springs are in all good high quality things like top of the line cassette recorders. But all of this stuff allows a drone to do cool things, like paint white dots on whatever the f*** you want. Dots on a tree? Done. Dot matrix rocks? You got it. Spotty bison? No f***ing worries.
Moo.
Or even convert your local park into an 80s stock market graph overlaid on a landscape. They can even do lines. Wavy lines and dots. Beep. Laser eyes. But apart from all these cool features, most importantly, there are bits that know when the drone's getting a bit on the piss. If you try and force one of these things sideways, it knows, and it'll control Z that sh** like that. But in answer to the question, how do drones actually do that? It's because of magic. Now let's move on and test this out. Now, sorry to disappoint, but obviously we know they're probably not gonna fly, and I didn't wanna just smash two expensive drones at the time, but I still want to know what would happen and how they would behave. And the good news is, unlike cats, it's pretty easy to trick drones into thinking they're already in the air. So I figured I should suspend them in the air while allowing them to pivot completely freely. And if done on a rope that's a little loose, we'll get an idea of where this bird might go if we let it out of its cage. So I've grabbed the drones and marked out the centers of the landing gear so we get them nice and balanced. Then I've used a PVC tube between the skids to act as a hub and then threaded the rope through. I've chucked some blocks of wood in, which I painted in Phantom Drone White. Then for the attachments, we'll use an elegant carbon fiber clamping system. Nah, f*** it, just a bunch of cable ties. Seems a bit loose. All the cable ties. Just trim them up and done. However, when I gave it a bit of a spin on my fingers, it turns out the Phantom 4 is slightly heavier. I probably should have thought of that when I'd previously read reviews that said the Phantom 4 is slightly heavier. So I thought the easiest way to get these guys balanced would be while they're on the rope. So it's rope time. I just strung up the rope between the columns in the shed and pulled it tight with a ratchet strap, which is also how I straightened up the entire shed when I f***ed it up while building it. I've then put it up on the rope and taped some weights onto the Phantom 3 to make the two evenly balanced. There we go. It's like an electronic ninja star or something. For the initial test, I just started one of the drones, and in theory it should stay upright due to all its internal robot guts telling it all the things about the Earth. He springs to life and you can hear him doing just that, doing everything he can to try and level out. He doesn't like being sideways at all. I even give him a little bump on the controls, but his AI says nah, not interested. And you can see here the wind from his props is making the props on the other drone spin. Maybe we could make a wind turbine generator that's powered by drones. Yeah, that's right, f*** you physics. I shut the Phantom 3 down, and then I give the Phantom 4 its own solo test as well. And his thrust spools up the other drone's props big time. I've then given the throttle full stick just to see what it does, and it seems to find itself in a bit of a death wobble, which is a bit worrying. But we've come this far with this dodgy test, so it's time to test this out with both drones running. And as an extreme safety measure, I've put a cushion on the ground under the drones. Okay class, before we start, maybe just for fun, have a bit of a guess in the comments before you watch with your theory on what you think will happen. Some of my guesses were that possibly the wash from each drone's propellers would simply cancel each other out, giving neither propulsion, and the drones would just kind of sit there doing a bunch of nothing. Or an awesome battle will happen with each trying to outmaneuver the other to be on top until a direction is established and they'll start looping over each other faster and faster in a perpetual butted cat spin. Or maybe there'll be some crap software thing and nothing will happen and I'll just make a video where nothing happens and just kind of talk about the history of camera guns. Okay, it is go time. I've roped Kristen into this dumb idea to control one of the drones. I've also chucked on a welding glove because it turns out they need to be level to allow the motors to start. So once it's running and staying level, I have to stick my hand in and force the thing upside down. Meanwhile, it'll be trying to lawnmower the shit out of my hand. It also turns out drones' cameras get really confused when they are inverted, so I had a bit of fun teasing their robot brains. Alright, enough of that. I have the Phantom 3 running and then force it upside down while it does everything it can to try and stop me. Then Kristen gets the Phantom 4 started. High-tech cable ties are holding up okay, and we're ready for this proof of concept perpetual cat rotation machine. I release them, and we're off! The later model Phantom 4 is just dominating it though. I reckon the Phantom 3 is having a fair crack at trying to flip him over. You can see him taking some quick, nervous glances up at the Phantom 4, but the P4 is just staring him down. I stick my hand into our new blender and then try and encourage a bit of a spin, but nothing. Oh, the Phantom 3 almost has it for a second there, but the P4's ground game is just too strong. He flips him back down every single time. Enthusiastic fist pump from Kristen there, either because it's a clear win by her Phantom 4, or that she knows I'll have to give up on my cat-on-cat perpetual motion dream and fix the laundry plumbing instead. It's a bugger I didn't have two of the same drone, because clearly we need two of the same model to have an equal test. Just as one last test though, I thought I'd level the playing field by removing the weights from the Phantom 3. We fire up the drones again, but it still looks like the Phantom 4 has the upper hand with its power advantage. We tried some advanced drone pilot techniques with the controls, you know, like flicking the sticks around with your thumbs and smashing the various buttons on the controls with our wrists, but it was no good. There is still no cat tape to a cat's perpetual spin happening. Personally, I'm pretty disappointed, but I guess it will save me the time in not bothering rounding up some cats. But overall, I guess this is a result. If you did have two cats and strap them together back to back for a free fall, the likelihood that one is slightly stronger than the other will always be a factor in the cat-on-cat perpetual motion machine. Have a think about subscribing so I can do more videos for you instead of fixing the laundry plumbing. I'm Craigo Turner, YouTube channel is Turner81, and something about next time.
Oh, tornado.